Hey Gloomers, welcome back to Nerdhaven. My name is Mike, and today I wanted to talk about the Frosthaven organizer options that are available for the Kickstarter backers. Now, the original intent was to include a Broken Token organizer, and if you haven't paid attention to what's happened with Broken Token, I'm not going to cover that here, but you can do a quick Google search and I'm sure you'll find it. Now, Frosthaven instead will be offering two options. The default will be a foam insert option, and that's going to be put out by Folded Space. And then they'll still have a wooden organizer option, and that will be created by LaserOx. Now I have the Broken Token organizer for Gloomhaven, and I'm pretty happy with it. There's some things that I don't like, but for the most part, I really like the style of it, and it fits pretty well. So I was leaning towards the wooden insert anyway, and so I wanted to check out what the LaserOx options would be like. I didn't know what their products were like. I'm not familiar with them as a company. And so I took a look what my options might be, and I have Jaws of the Lion. I haven't opened it, I haven't played it yet. It was still brand new in the box, but I don't have an organizer for it. And so I figured this would be a great opportunity for me to order the LaserOx insert for Jaws of the Lion and get a sense of what their build quality was like, how well it was put together. And I figured I'd make a quick video where I put it together and I talk about my thoughts after taking a look at their products. So here's a quick time lapse of me building it. So now that that's put together, let's take a look at what it looks like when it's all packed up inside the box, and I'm going to take it apart and talk about my thoughts as I go through. So here on top, you'll see here's all the paperwork. This so far looks exactly what it looks like when you open it up for the first time. All the booklets and stickers are stacked on top. Underneath that, you'll have the map of the city of Gloomhaven. I also have the piece of paper that came with the organizer, and it just has a quick guide on how to put it back in the box, just in case that you have everything out and you forget. Once you take the map out, you'll see you have your, the tracker for the elements on top. You also have a little tray that has the envelopes and cards for the monster stats. It also has some of the monster standees. The monster stat card has this little slot where you can actually stand it up. Now, I don't really think this is particularly useful because you can only do it for one enemy and you can't track conditions or hit points that way. I think they just needed to make the tray the size of the envelope. So, but it is an option if you wanted to use that as a stand-up. This other tray has some bosses and some other monsters. Under that, there's another tray with some additional enemies. And after that, we have this other box. Now there's an acrylic top here that helps keep all of these tokens inside. This has all the coins, the damage tokens, and all of the overlay tiles. So your treasure chests, your traps, things like that. And the wood actually kind of holds in the tabs on the edges. And you can see if you turn it upside down, nothing falls out. But the cover actually snaps into place pretty well. And it's pretty sturdy. I don't think it's going to fall out accidentally. These little boxes, there's four of them. You can use those to store your attack modifier decks for each of the four players. In this box, you'll see I have the standee bases, the condition cards, and I don't actually love the way they design this because you see the standees and the condition tokens are things that you actively use during gameplay. The other things you actually use during setup. So you have your elements, your the important markers for when there's scenario conditions that might pop up, and your initiative tracker. So we'll talk about that a little bit more in a second. That's one of my, gripes a little bit with this organizer. So you saw here, I kind of took out some of the other monsters who were in another tray. There's a separate tray that holds the city event cards. This box right here has all of the monster or enemy ability cards, and they're labeled. So they're really easy to get to, and you can pull them right out, shuffle them up, and put them right into play pretty easily. After that, you also have your enemy attack modifier deck, your items, and then it also has the bless cards and the curse cards for both the monster and the enemies. You can see here this little sword icon lines right up with the same sword icon that's on the back of the items, and so it's another indicator that tells you sort of what's where within the box. Now this is one of the gripes I have with this. See this tab at the bottom here of this side panel? This side panel has a sword on it, and with many of these organizers, including this one, the tabs are slightly different sizes to help make sure that you put it together the right way. And if you notice here, the skull that sort of matches the enemy is on this side, and I think the sword is supposed to be over here. I swear when I put this together, the instructions said to do it this way. I may have made a mistake. I threw them away by the time I realized it happened, but this could have been prevented if the slot was a different size for both ends. That would have made sure that you lined it up in the correct end. So I think that was a little bit of a design flaw. It can help prevent people from, making a mistake if it was my fault. The last thing, this is my other gripe with this. You see all the boxes for the standees are over here, and then tucked in a little slot is the battle goals. And there's a lot of empty space here. There's nothing else that they built for it. It just sort of floats around. So the cards can slide around a bit. The boxes can slide around. And the way I looked at this, I actually thought this would be a good opportunity to have created one more box that you could have stored your initiative trackers, your elements, and the other markers there. And those would have been all things that are part of the setup. And it would have held everything together easier, so you don't have an empty space. This would have been right under where the board for the elements is located, so it would make sense to sort of have it in the same location. And if you had done that and moved those there, it would have made more space in this box. So instead of having all the conditions just tucked into this really tight space, you could have had dividers and actually kept them separated, a lot easier to pull out when you're playing. And really, one of the purposes of an organizer is to make playing easier. So I think that was a missed design opportunity. Overall, I still think it's a good product and it's designed well, but that seemed like something that I was pretty surprised as they iterated and came up with what the design for this would be, I was surprised that they didn't sort of think of that on their own. So you can see all these sort of stack back up. The acrylic tops help hold the tokens in, and then this top one has walls on the side so that this final tray slides in between those walls. And everything starts to fit back together here. And the last piece I didn't mention before, but the element card, the height of these boxes actually gets a little higher on the side, and that creates a little bit of a lip so that that element card stays in place in the corner there and it doesn't float around the box. And that's it. Everything else fits in here. You can stack all the booklets right back on top. And one other thing that I noticed is when you close the box and turn it on its side, there is no lid lift. This is the same height, and you could see a little bit of a lip there, but that's normal. That's actually what the normal Jaws of the Lion game looked like before I even took it out of the box. So now let's talk a little bit about build quality. The quality of the wood and the precision of the cuts is right on par with Broken Token. Now, I'll be honest, if it didn't have a logo on it and you showed the box to me, I would have guessed it's a Broken Token product. It looks identical to me. And again, outside of the logo, the quality of the wood looks exactly the same. Even the style of how the notches are cut out and everything fits together looks very much like Broken Token. So if you like Broken Token's products and that's what you were expecting, you will absolutely like the LaserOx product. It's more or less identical. I would actually even make the case that the LaserOx product, at least for Jaws of the Lion, spent more time customizing the cuts so that the shapes of some of the boxes were actually thematic to Gloomhaven rather than in Broken Token sort of default, bland style. And so, you know, I think that LaserOx has a couple of things actually going for it in that space. I also mentioned there were a couple of things I didn't love about the design choices for the Jaws of the Lion organizer, but I will say that the Broken Token organizer for Gloomhaven had some similar issues. I didn't love that you had to have four classes unpacked in the character boxes in order for the other envelopes to fit in the box. It wasn't a big deal for us because we played a four-player campaign, but if we were a two- or three-player campaign, I would have found that pretty annoying. And I also didn't like that the tray just sort of floated on top with all the map tiles and it creates some lid lift. I felt like for Broken Token being such a popular organizer company, they should have found a way to fit everything together a bit cleaner. I know some of the other organizers are able to do it without lid lift. So again, you know, the LaserOx wasn't perfect, but the Broken Token one for me and for Gloomhaven wasn't either. So those are my thoughts. I'm curious, you know, I'm going to go ahead and order the LaserOx one. I'm curious what you're going to order. If you're going to order the foam or if you're going to order the wooden one, let me know in the comments down below. I wanted to talk just quickly about some upcoming videos I have. I mentioned before that I was going through and I was revising all of the original Gloomhaven classes into a Frosthaven style of mat and player cards. And so I've made some progress on that. I have Diviner more or less completed, and I have that available as a TTS mod. So you can actually go on. There'll be a link in the description below. But you can actually go and you can subscribe to that mod in the workshop. So if you want to play on TTS enhanced 1.2 or above, you can use that and you can play around with it. I'm still making some tweaks to it. I'm keeping it in beta because I'm sure I'll make some changes to fix some things as people give me feedback. But overall, it should be fully functional. I also wanted to cover that in a video, so I'm going to talk through exactly what my approach was. So that'll be one of my upcoming videos. And then the last piece is I provided the template that I'm using to make all the Frosthaven updates. So for anybody who's doing custom classes, if there's something that you wanted to do there, I'll have a link to that below, but I do have a Photoshop template that you can use to start putting together the Frosthaven style cards instead of the old Gloomhaven style. So if you found this video interesting, please share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my content, please consider subscribing. It'll really support the channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.